Hey there, Bigger Pockets. It's Matt Faircloth here. Today we're going to talk about why it's important to become a leader in your local real estate community. And you could be a leader, or you could be just a participant or whatever it is, but you want to be an active voice in your local real estate community, and here's why. This is my very good friend and business associate, Roland Pott. He and I just spent this morning speaking at a breakfast for a local bank that was just putting on a community of real estate investors for deals that they have, and for just a community of investors and people that are concerned and active in the local real estate market. Because Roland and I are related to this bank and we've done some work with them, and also are just in relations with the folks that run the operations over there and are aware of this breakfast that they have once a quarter, he and I both got to speak. I was on a panel. Roland actually got about a 20-minute or so time for himself to come and present some projects he's up to. So it was great benefit for me to be on the panel, a great benefit for Roland too. And we're going to talk about a few different ways that you can get yourself integrated in your local real estate communities, and also just the benefits of doing it. So Roland, why do you think it's important for investors out there to be active in their real estate communities? What are the benefits for them in this?
Mm-hmm. Well, that's a great question. I think that first and foremost, and thanks for having me on Bigger Pockets as well, and having you on your podcast. It's a great opportunity, and I appreciate the value that you're delivering to the people that are watching your blog as well. It's great. So I think that it's important for investors to be out in front of the community and in front of other real estate investors so that they can kind of deliver some value to others. At the end of the day, I think people are going to listen to us as thought leaders when we are giving them some good information that they can use in their business. So today, in my opportunity to speak a little bit in front of this breakfast club, it was basically an opportunity to tell my story. And so I chose to focus a little bit in on adaptive reuse of buildings and renovation of historic buildings and the development of mixed-use buildings. So those were certain things that I have experience with that I could talk about, and things that I could tell my own story about. And I tried to do it in a way that would give some good information that other people would benefit from. And so that's really why I think it's important to get in front of other investors, is that you want to show that you're an expert in what you do. Mm-hmm. In a humble way, not trying to make it out like you're a big shot, but that you're an expert in what you do. And I think the best way to do that is just by telling your story. Mm-hmm. And when you tell your story, you know, what I tried to do is talk about what was good, what was successful, as well as things I would change the next time through. Because that's going to be real, and that's what people are going to learn from. And if I can learn from my mistakes, then hopefully the next person can learn from them as well. So that's the important thing, and that's what real thought leaders do, is they are honest about their experiences, and they talk about what they've done and why they're able to keep doing what they do.
Yeah, I like what you said about telling your story when you get into a venue like that, because people that are active in your local market want to hear how you got where you're going, and they also may have an alignment with that. That if you talk about some things that you're working on that are in your pipeline, maybe there's a way they can help you carry that forward. And only by being active in your local real estate community could they help you carry forward that vision.
Go ahead. I was just going to respond to that. I think it's a great point that people are going to be in alignment. So after this particular conversation we had, a woman came up to me and she said, "Thank you for your talk. I really liked it. I have a property in a town in New Jersey where they just changed the zoning, and it's a barn, and now it's a very deep property. It's an acre. There's a lot of pedestrian traffic. Retail is now possible at this site. It's across from a bank. There's a good amount of activity there. Please, would you come down and check it out? Or do you know anybody that might be interested in this particular development site?" And so that was a good opportunity. She was interested because she heard that it was sort of related to my area of expertise. It may or may not be an opportunity for me. It may be something that I can pass on to somebody else. But it wouldn't have happened if I hadn't spoken about adaptive reuse and these kinds of subjects. So those are the connections that you're talking about. You get out in front of somebody, you create alignments, you create referrals, and it starts to make things happen.
And you never know where these conversations are going to go. So Roland, how do you think that, so you've got maybe somebody that's watching here is either a newer investor or an investor that's done some work in the business, but is not currently in front of an audience, but wants to be, that wants to do either some speaking or wants to get some exposure for what they're up to in some of these communities that are typically just third-party entities that are just putting conversations out there for people to listen to. What's the best way for someone to get involved in either like a breakfast club like you and I did, or maybe a local chamber of commerce or whatever it is that has real estate conversations on a regular basis that these folks could participate in? How does it happen?
How do you start? That's a good question.
So
a couple ways. One is I would encourage investors to document and journal your experiences as you do your first real estate project. Or if it's your 20th real estate project, document and journal it. That could be as simple as taking some snapshots on the cell phone as you go. Before and after pics are always great topics of conversation. Videos, just some notes on a pad of paper as you go through it. Some pictures of your contractor, some pictures that you take with your vendors. These kinds of things are what make for good information and conversation later on. So once you've documented it, then you can do a slideshow. And that can then you can develop a slideshow, you can have a photo album, but you have something to talk about. From there, you can get all kinds of opportunities to share your experience. So it could be someone invites you to talk about your experience in your investment. It could be as simple as where you start, you get a few friends together at the local diner, at the local coffee shop, and say, you know what, I just finished a project, or I'm in the middle of a project and it's going along really well. I've been taking some pictures, I'd like to share them. Come on out, I'll buy you a cup of coffee, and you know, I'm gonna do a little presentation about what I'm going through. That's how it could start. And from there, once you've been able to answer some questions from folks and spark some interest, well, you know what? Then you may be invited to speak again. Not only that, you can partner with your vendors. That's the other thing that I've seen done really successfully. So let's say you're gonna do a house renovation and you buy cabinets from a local cabinet company, and you have a local contractor that installs them for you or something like that. Well, why not ask your cabinet guy to come and do a joint presentation with you at the cabinet company's store? You know, something like that. This way, both of you are aligned in your interest and you can start to talk together about what your experience has been like. Both of you are promoting your businesses, you're promoting each other's businesses, and that can work out really well as well.
That's a great idea. And again, the entity that we were speaking for today for this breakfast club was a local bank that gets real estate investors together. Maybe they get a loan out of it, or maybe they just facilitate some interesting conversations about the local real estate market and who knows where it goes. So great, working with vendors is a great idea. I'll also throw out there that for those of you that are that have a local real estate club in your area, it's got to be a wholesome real estate club, not one of these clubs that's just centered on getting folks to run to the back of the room to buy them the latest package for a couple of $1,000s. But there are real estate entities that are out there that really just want to put good speakers out, that want to facilitate some networking and maybe some deals happening across the table and that kind of thing. So find your local real estate club and volunteer for that entity, or find a way to just support them and find out what, because they're typically understaffed and they need people that are willing to contribute some of their time. And I find that if you're willing to invest your time and your resources into helping these entities grow, be that the local chamber of commerce, be that a local real estate entity, and whatnot, if you're willing to invest your time, they will reward you in whatever way that they can. They're probably not going to financially compensate you. They're definitely not going to do that in most instances, but they will find a way to get back to you in some form or fashion. It might not happen for the first 6 months or a year, but if you put in your dues in working with those entities, they will find a way to give you a return, be that put you in front of the room, be that, you know, get you some introductions that you may need to get yourself, to advance your brand through your local community. I mean, I know you've done well with that through local chambers of commerce as well.
Yeah, I think that's a great point. You know, local not-for-profit organizations are also always looking for board members. And they're looking for business people, because oftentimes you have local not-for-profits. Let's say it's a local food bank, or let's say it's a pet rescue organization, or let's say it's a child, something having to do with benefiting children, or something with that's health related, any number of local not-for-profits that are providing services to those that need help. Oftentimes they don't have the financial oversight, or the people that are willing to do fundraising, or the people that are willing to do bookkeeping, or different kinds of things like that that have business expertise. And so volunteering as a board member for some of these organizations can be very helpful, and then it also means that you can give your business savvy and your business expertise for this organization that might need help paying the bills, or might need help keeping on a firm financial footing. So that's a good way to do it. And you know, not-for-profits are also always looking for volunteers, as you mentioned. So, you know, what about a local race? Maybe there's a local 5K that wants somebody to give out water at the water stop. Maybe it's worth making a small investment to get your logo on the back of the t-shirt that is given out at that race.
Yeah.
And then, again, you get more exposure, you get to talk to people at the race, and this way you get you get more exposure that way too. This is a way of making connections, which later lead to speaking engagements, but also it's relationship building.
Yeah. It's a longer-term investment, but I find that those can be the most fruitful long-term, because they continue to grow long after you've made that investment in that local community. So, as Roland said, it could be volunteering on the not-for-profit board. It could be, just whatever it may be, but the more investment you make in that up front, again, you've got to be willing to play the long game to really benefit on this side. So I can't underscore that enough, that this is something that you invest in now and put some of your time in now, and it's something that can give you a return through relationships many, many years into the future. So I hope this has been a benefit, guys. Roland and I have done very well through being active in our local real estate communities and local communities overall, and the places that we do business. It's a great way to raise your brand and a great way to contribute to organizations that are doing good around us. And you know, it's a good way to get to know people, and also to have people know what you do. And it can generate referrals. Roland and I both got referrals for our businesses today, basis the speaking engagement. So please do leave some comments below. I wanted to thank you, Roland, for participating. This has been great having you here.
Thank you.
As a part of our Bigger Pockets community and broadcasting some stuff you and I are up to. So leave some comments below, guys, if you have any questions or you want to get a conversation going on some things that you're involved in your local community, or ways that you've been able to elevate your brand by getting involved in folks that are local as well. So thanks for watching, and I look forward to speaking to you soon. Have a good day.
Bye-bye. Thanks.